So how does an advertiser benefit from Taboola when compared to, say, Google or Facebook ads? I understand it's pretty much complementary, but is there a lower, let's say, CPC, or for a low budget, can he expect to reach a lot of audience? What is a USP for an advertiser?
So I'll start from the end for your question. So yes, probably you can get a better CPC in terms of what you can get somewhere else, but you need to remember that the premium quality of the audience is very, very high on discovery platform, when other platforms are just reaching a lot of reach without knowing if it's good or not. And that's the benefits of Taboola. So from the media perspective, from the advertiser perspective, it's not just about how much I'm paying. Might be I'm gonna pay very, very low, but I'm not gonna get my KPIs. I'm not gonna achieve my targets. On the other end, I'm willing to pay a little extra, but to achieve all of my targets and maybe even exceeding the targets. So that's the idea behind discovery platform. We need to remember, search is great for search. Social is great for social. If you are using only those two categories, you're still missing a lot of customers that are somewhere else, that are not searching what they are searching right now, or they're not on social apps, and then they are on the open web. The open web, we are the platform of the open web. So if you have a strategy to use only social, you missed a lot of search and discovery. If you have only the search, then you're missing the social and the discovery. You need to have all of them baked into your strategy. And the most important thing, check what's the quality of every platform, and then you will know what to use.
Sure. So do you give only CPC kind of ads, or do you also provide, like, you said performance ads. So what is exactly performance ads?
So performance ads is campaigns that are targeting a specific acquisition, we call it CPA, cost per acquisition, either leads or email or specific sales activities, maybe you are a specific URL, maybe followers, maybe membership. It can be a lot of things. What Taboola will do is that we're going to charge you based on CPC, but we're going to do, the system knows how to do a very optimization process in order to accommodate the CPA targets that you gave us. We have also smart bid, which is actually you're allowing us to play with the bid and to lower all the time the CPC according to the KPIs and the achievement that we are showing you. So it's more than just CPC or CPA. We're going to charge you by CPC, but we're going to optimize everything to your CPA. And we have the smart bid that allow us to play with it and to lower all the time the CPC according to the achievements that we are showing you.
So the smart bid is like automatic, like the publisher doesn't have to...
They don't need to play with it all the time. You can't be on top of it all the time. It's an algorithm. So yes, you allow the algorithm to optimize all the time automatically for your KPIs.
Oh. So is there a minimum, value required for advertisers? Like they come in and say a couple of thousand dollars?
So I would say a couple of thousand dollars is good enough. I'm not going to say one line. So I would love to help small businesses and medium businesses to grow with us. But in general, you need to have a couple of thousands of dollars in order to allow the algorithm to learn the system, to understand. The algorithm need to understand the content so they can find the right content to the right user. So we need to make the niche match, and we need to allow the algorithm to understand what is the best user for this type of content.
Right. So are there any content guidelines that advertisers need to follow? What are the normal cases where you reject a particular type of an advertisement?
It's a full policy, so I can't have everything right now, but I will say, of course, every issue which is illegal, like drugs and weapon and stuff like this, and nude and porn, we don't allow. There are specific images that we're not going to allow on our network. So if you're making an advertiser for gym and you're going to show everyone just with bra and some underwear, that's not going to work also. We need to be very careful that we have responsibilities to serve the audience with the right stuff. There is a policy section within Taboola site, and the best way is to go over there and to check. And you also have an account manager that can help you to understand which is the right thing to do and what are the right thing not to do.
So primarily, Taboola ads are like content, and I mean in the sense written content like blog post or a video. So is there also an image kind of an ad which Taboola supports?
We support everything: images, articles, video, galleries, So it's a kind of an image. We are supporting everything, but it depends on what you want to achieve. According to that, we can give you the right recommendation how to achieve it. But we're open for everything.
Okay. So is there an auction system to determine which ads get showed to, first, or which ads get showed on, let's say, I want my ad on Times of India. So how do I, is there a guarantee that, okay, this ad will go on this publication?
No, the answer is no, because we are not focusing on the publisher side. We are focusing on the user interface and the user experience. So from my perspective, if the user right now is on Times of India or NDTV or India Today or The Hindu, wherever they are, I want to show them the right content. So from the advertiser perspective, the best way to do is to allow the algorithm to find me the right users and to attract them wherever they are. So it's not about a specific publisher. Yes, you need to know what's the KPIs, what you're trying to achieve, and then to go to achieve it within the platform. So don't think about the publisher, because you think that I'm reading only right now NDTV, but might be that I'm on a Cricket Info or whatever other, or Bollywood Chatties or whatever other sites I am in, and then Taboola can find you wherever you are and attract you with the right content.
Okay. So do you have a self-service portal for publishers?
Yes, we do. We do have self-service for media side and also for publisher side. I do recommend for publisher to contact Taboola, because it's better to understand all the advantages and sometimes through the wizard or the self-serve system, you can't really understand it. But on the media side, for example, it's very easy, very intuitive, and you can do through the wizard a lot of things.
And the same applies to advertisers also, I guess.
Correct. Yes, that's what I said. The wizard is for the media side. For the advertisers, it's very intuitive and very easy to
And just one last question. What is this native content? Because Taboola's site highlights that quite prominently. So what is this native content?
People calling this kind of advertisement, call it native. I'm not a big fan of it, because I think that native is a word that describes something differently from publisher to publisher. Some publisher call native this, and some publisher call native this. So I don't really like to use the word native. I prefer to use more discovery platform, because discovery platform help you to discover new things, and the format doesn't mean anything. So it can be video, which is not native, but it can be very native. It can be content, it can be gallery, it can be everything you want. So it depends on what you're trying to achieve, and that's why you're using discovery platform. Native is kind of an old way of doing things. So from my perspective, I'm looking forward and into discovery world and not into the native old days format.
So does content explanatory content or informative content, do they work better than, let's say, an e-commerce ad kind of?
I will say that stories work better than just ads. If you show me just what we call the dry ad or something that's just going to show your product, it's probably going to work less on the majority of the people if you're going to tell them a story. Story, it's much more engaging, it's much more, it's work, it's making an impact. So from our perspective, the funnel is the right funnel through content and a story and not just by an ad. And by the way, the data shows that what I'm saying is what's actually happening day by day by the audiences, not by me. The users love to click on stories and to consume content and not just to get ads, what we call in the face.